Hello everyone, in this video I'm introducing slide pools and slide randomization in ActivePresenter. As you know, when creating your quiz to minimize the probability that answers are predictable by learners, questions should be randomly picked from a question bank or question pool. ActivePresenter allows you to create question pools with random questions for your project. However, we use random slide and slide pool concepts instead of random question and question pool. This design allows you to create a quiz with random content, including not only questions but any supported slide objects. To create a quiz with random content, the first thing we have to do is creating a slide pool. Now I'm opening a project containing some questions in it. Normally, when this project is exported to HTML5, both the slide order and slide content are fixed. Now, I will apply slide randomization function on this project. To create a slide pool, click on View, then select Slide Pools. A slide pool's window pops up with a default pool. The default slide pool contains no slide. Now, to add more slides in the slide pool, you could do the same as inserting new slides in a project. Then, insert content into that new slide. When editing, you could switch to work with slide in either slide paint or slide pool just by clicking at them. I will delete the slide in pool on here and move some slides from the slide paint into the pool. After selecting slides in slide paint, right click and select move to from the list, then select pool on. After moving the slides, I have one slide left in slide paint and a slide pool with 6 slides. In the next step, we will create some new random slides. Click the slide tab to add a new slide in the slide paint. Then, click random slide. A random slide with dark background now appears. By default, this new random slide is linked with the first slide pool in the project. If there are more than one pool in your project, you could link the random slide to any other pool. To do so, select Property Paint in Link Pool section. Choose the pool you want to link with. Here, I will create 2 new slides to illustrate next steps more easily. After the setting, now when exporting to HTML5, slide 1 will be on random slide in pool 1, slide 2 will be another random slide from pool 1, which is different from slide 1. And slide 3 will be any slide from pool 1 that doesn't duplicate slide 1 and 2. If the number of random slides linked with one pool is greater than the number of slides in that pool, ActivePresenter will show you a warning. Now we will export the project to HTML5 and see the result. I'm refreshing the browser to represent different times of taking the quiz. As you see, the slide contents change after each refreshment. By adding new slide pools, you can have more than one slide pool in a project. That is best used when you want to ensure that questions are randomly picked but still cover all contents at different levels. For example, if you want to have 2 easy and 1 difficult questions in your quiz, you can set up so that pool 1 contains easy questions and pool 2 has difficult ones. Then link slide 1 and 2 to pool 1 and slide 3 to pool 2. Additionally, you could change the pool name to manage pools easily. If you delete a slide pool, all slides linked to the deleted pool will be linked to the first pool in the project. You could also import existing pools in other presentations to reuse. Moreover, you can track the information of slide pool as well as the slides linked with it. So now you have been introduced all functions of slide pools and slide randomization in ActivePresenter. Thank you for watching.